Ho, 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 boys and girls. Welcome back to another Dicon Dissectional production, hosted by this nice young man, Deathstroke 9.
And also my special guest, Santa Claus, apparently.
Ho, ho, ho.
So Santa, what is the gift that we're going to be listening to tonight?
Tonight's gift is going to be Santana, Soul Sacrifice, from 1969, Woodstock. I don't know how I feel about a soul sacrifice.
Your name is an anagram for Satan, so I think we'll figure out how you feel about that. All right. Hello, everyone. Welcome back.
Welcome back, Legion.
Yeah. So we're going to be reacting to... This is my first reaction to Santana on the channel. I think there's one song by them that I have heard before, right? I think. Which one is it? I don't know.
I don't know all the music you've listened to.
I know, but normally music that I'll hear... It'll be if I'm in the car with you.
Maybe Black up. Magic Woman, Oyo Como Va.
That first one might be it. Right. Maybe. All right. Yeah.
So I've never heard this song.
And this is live. Multiple people have requested this. And a lot of people have just requested that I do anything by Santana. So I'm excited to check this out. And yeah, link to the original video will be down below in the description. If you're new to the channel, you know, consider subscribing. I think you've heard it everywhere else. Yeah, 1969 Woodstock. Have we done anything from Woodstock on the channel? I don't think we have.
I think you've done a song called Woodstock.
I have. That is true. But I've never reacted to anything from anything from Woodstock. So excited to check this out. All right.
Sure.
Yeah, it's a 6-minute long video, so I'm excited to see where this goes. And a lot of people told me this group is like really good musically, so I'm excited. All right. I tried to pull the lyrics up, and we had some difficulties. First, we had lyrics that was all in Spanish over here. That's about Puerto Rico, Colombia, Venezuela, China, Japan, and Mexico. I'm not sure if... I'm pretty sure those lyrics are wrong.
I'm going to guess that those lyrics are right.
Oh, are correct. Okay.
Right, so he's probably singing to more than just... America or Woodstock,
sure.
New York. So,
But then when I looked it up on genius.com, it came up with a soul sacrifice, a love supreme. Don't try this at home. We're not listening to this for the lyrics.
I want to hear some good music.
Let's go. 3, 2, 1. Santana, Soul Sacrifice.
Soul sacrifice.
Get into a trance.
Look at how many people are there.
He's part of the band.
Really? Yeah, okay.
Look how young he looks.
He's turning it up as low as we'll go.
Nice bass.
cowbell.
Sorry. All right. Should that be the only time I pause it? Probably.
Sure.
So far, incredible musically. The bass coming in, the drums, awesome. I don't really want to stop it, so I think I'm just going to go right back.
Go ahead.
Yeah, let's keep going. They're drawing it forth. Okay, so first of all, very first thing I need to say, those lyrics, am I right? Second, the second thing that almost doesn't have to do with the song is, did you see that freaking crowd?
Sure.
Woodstock's crowd is incredible. Anyway, all right, so the bass was awesome, the guitar solo was awesome, the drums, though, like the drumming was like a very major part of... Like, a lot of times, bands use drums, you know, to keep rhythm, and then they'll use, like, drum fills while other music is going on at the same time. With this, are those, like, bongos that they're playing?
Yeah.
They were doing, like, a solo on that, you know, with almost nothing else behind it. It was very interesting. I really like that. So, all right, what were you going to say? Sorry.
A few things stuck out to me watching that. First, the one thing that really, it just kept replaying in my head was, it looked like Santana and the bass player, to an extent, it looked like they were on leashes. They were plugged into their amplifiers and their cords. So when we watch today, everything is wireless. People can move around, go wherever they want. It looks like they were almost stationary, not really stationary, but confined to a 4-foot by 4-foot area. For some reason, sure. That stuck out to me.
It was interesting, especially since, like, they seem very energetic, you know? So are you, so if what you're saying, you know, you're saying that they could have been, like, running around, like, dead, you know?
What stood out to me, though, it seemed a lot of repetition. When he was playing, it was certainly very good, but the music was just repetitious until the crescendo. So sure. The last 2 minutes, it was a build-up to that last 2 minutes of that song.
Yeah, sure.
I definitely thought the bongos gave it more of like a Caribbean style, so a little bit different than a lot of the music that you would typically hear. Those bongos definitely added a different element.
They added like a
Latin kind of feel to it.
Like a cultural background to it.
So I painted
a picture behind it a little bit of where it's coming from. And then the name of the song kind of drove what I was hearing a little bit, I guess. Just hearing the name Soul Sacrifice when I'm listening to it, I'm like, the ritual has begun, you know?
Yeah. It definitely was almost like trance music.
It was really cool. You know, I liked it. Thank you. Thank you guys for telling me to react to Santana. I'm glad you could join me for
it.
Since there's not a lot of lyrics and we're not, you know, music teachers or anything, is there, I mean, let me think. What would there be to add? Because we've got a 12-minute long video so far. So, you never went to a Woodstock, did you? I don't think so, right?
Maybe. The closest thing that I came to going to any type of Woodstock would be, I went to Ozfest numerous times.
Okay.
And I went to Lollapalooza 1 year.
Oh, okay.
Which, being from South Florida, it probably took place in August. It was 100 degrees, and it was probably a 10-hour concert.
Okay.
And it was, while the lineup was really, really good, it might be one of the most miserable experiences. And it's hard to offset that, right? It's hard to balance that out because the music, the lineup was really, really good. And it wasn't your typical Lollapalooza. I think Soundgarden played, Metallica played, the Ramones played, Rage Against the Machine played.
The Ramones
played. Yes, the Ramones. Yep.
Okay.
But I do remember being up front for hours on end, and there was a board, like you saw up there, a board. Guardrail. And I remember young ladies getting between the guardrail, and there was probably 60,000 people all pushing up front. And it's 100 degrees, and my arms by the end of the night, like, they hurt for 3 weeks just trying to protect whoever was in front of me. And there was not nearly enough water. Where I know back at Woodstock, it was a lot worse than what I had to endure at Lollapalooza. But
that's what I've heard, too. Like, when I did the song Woodstock, right, there were a lot of different types of comments. You know, there were, like, it was almost a 50-50 split, you know. There would be a lot of people who were like, Woodstock was a magical moment when a bunch of these huge bands came together and a very, very large group of people gathered together to experience the music together. Might have gotten high on different substances. Who knows?
Said you might have.
Okay. They got high on different substances. But then other people were like, yeah, you had to be high on some type of substance to endure it. It was crazy and difficult, you know. So there's different experiences, obviously, you know. I have secondhand experiences. That's it. And then watching videos like this, which are obviously up close. You know, can you imagine being in the back row at Woodstock?
I've been to lots of concerts.
Sure.
And normally I feel safe and in control. And even if I went slam dancing, I knew that I could get out most of the times. That Lollapalooza experience for me.
You couldn't get out.
Yeah, you were stuck. Ooh, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yep.
If you did get out, you weren't getting back. You know what I mean? And I was in the front, like the stage was 20 feet away from me. So I wanted to enjoy the experience, and I was young in my 20s to where I knew it was an experience that I wanted to partake in. I didn't want to leave. But when the force of people pushing you know what I mean?
Yeah.
There comes a point of time, and you've been out there for such a long time. Every once in a while, they'd spray these hoses of water, like industrial-sized hoses of water to kind of cool you down a little bit. But it really didn't do much. But it was just an uncomfortable environment.
That's horrible.
And there's too many people there that you could quite possibly be trampled. Who knows what could happen?
Exactly. When I've thought about concerts before, I feel like smaller venues are probably better to go to. Because you can get the experience better, I think. And
The Lollapalooza, there was no... So it was at the West Palm Beach Amphitheater. But it was like... I've been to lots of concerts there where they have general seating and it's up on a hill. So you have these seats with an overhang. Then you have a hill. So general seating would be up on the hill where it's first come, first serve.
Okay.
And you could have seats. This was... part of like the fairgrounds, so there was no seats. It wasn't at the amphitheater. It was in the same location.
Why didn't they put it there?
Because the amphitheater could hold 15 or 20,000 people. There was 60,000 people. So it wasn't like an area where you could say, "Okay, I'm going to sit." You know what I mean?
Sure.
And as the evening progressed, more and more and more people before, like you could turn behind you, and it was just a sea of people.
It's crazy.
It's certainly those are unique experiences, but it's not like you could phone a friend or you could ask Regis for a lifeline or something.
Sure.
You know,
there's no getting
so
out of it.
Anyway, that would be my closest experience to a Woodstock type environment, I think.
So to sum up, I like this. I enjoyed the video. I like the song. I like seeing them perform it. I recognize the name Santana, but I really couldn't name a song by them. So it was really cool seeing them. They seem like a very...
I've never heard that.
You've never heard that before?
No.
Yeah. All right. Should I see if there's any song facts on it before we say goodbye? Thank you for joining me once again. Thank you all for joining me as well. Get out lyrics and just put meaning. Alright, there is song facts on it. This did not chart. It's off the album Santana. This instrumental piece is the closing track on their debut album. It's powered by a two conga attack of Michael Carabello and Jose Arias. Am I saying that? Arias?
Sure.
Arias? Whatever. With Carlos Santana cutting in at various intervals with blistering guitar licks. This African, Latin, so you got that right, rock hybrid was new, different, and exciting and became a signature sound for the group. Soul Sacrifice wasn't hit material. Instrumental tracks running 6 minutes and 37 seconds rarely are, but it quickly became a fan favorite and endured as a staple of their live shows. The first place most listeners heard this was at Woodstock, where it was one of the more memorable performances of the iconic festival. Santana was a popular live draw in the San Francisco area, but they had yet to release their first album. They got an invite to Woodstock only at the behest of their manager, a heavy hitter named Bill Graham. Okay, that's pretty cool. They took the stage as the third act on... Oh, so this is going to have some backstory. That's cool.
Sure.
As the third act on day two, going on around 2 p.m., Carlos Santana thought they were going to go on much later. Oh, okay. So he took...
some masculine.
Yeah. Supplied by his friend, Jerry Garcia, of course. Okay. And was peaking when the performance started. And the entire band seemed to be on another level of musical consciousness throughout the set. Yeah. Yeah, I was wondering when I watched, like, the expressions that they had. All right.
So by the time they played Soul Sacrifice, their seventh number, They were locked in with each other and with the crowd. It captured the spirit of the festival, with everyone sharing a positive energy and putting any differences aside. Santana's self-titled debut album was released 2 weeks later in the halo of their Woodstock performance.
This was perfect. Stars aligned.
2 million copies in America and put the band on the path to stardom.
The 8-minute Woodstock performance was included on the official soundtrack from the festival. Leading into the track was the No Rain chant from the crowd, which actually took place the next day after Joe Cocker's set, but segued nicely into the opening groove, Soul Sacrifice. The writer's credits on the song go to four guys who crafted it during jam sessions in San Francisco. Santana, David Brown, keyboard man Greg Raleigh, and percussionist Marcus Malone.
So that keyboard man, he was making love to that keyboard.
Oh, that is true. Yes. Yeah. So I talked about the guitar, the bass, and the bongos. The thing that I mainly remember from the other Santana song that I heard, which probably is why I remember the name, is the keyboard or the organ or whatever was really, really, really good, you know?
Sure.
Do you think is that a signature part of Santana's music?
I think the keyboard was relevant in lots of music back in the 60s and
70s. Okay, yeah. All right. Malone was an original member of the band but missed out on the glory when he went to jail for manslaughter before Woodstock and before their first album was released. He got out in 1973 and ended up homeless. That's really sad. In 2013, a TV news crew reunited him with Carlos.
The Woodstock version of the song is included in the 30th anniversary of the re-release of Santana's debut album as a bonus track along with the live version of Savior.
And previously unreleased Fried Neck Bones and some home fries. All right. Thank you for joining me, Santa. That was a great gift.
Ho, ho, ho.
Santana, you know. When I went to type in Santana, first thing that came up was Santa stuff. I need to do Christmas music reactions. All right. Thank you very much for joining me. And
thank you, guys.
Thank you for joining me as well. And if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. We are Legion, my friends. Deathstroke 9.
Peace and love.
It's so fun doing these.
Ho, ho, ho. Peace and love.